Hi friends, watch the full video for stepwise recipe and no fail tips to turn your regular breakfast to interesting one. Hope you like this. Welcome to Avi's Delights. Want to be the first one to see our videos? Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. Ingredients: potatoes 2 medium size, onion finely chopped 2, grated carrot 1/2 cup, frozen peas 1/4 cup, curry leaves 5 to 6, green chilies 2 numbers, mustards 1 teaspoon, cumins 1 teaspoon, urad dal 1 teaspoon, chana dal 1 teaspoon, asafoetida 1/4 teaspoon, turmeric 1/2 teaspoon, coriander 3 teaspoons, ghee 2 teaspoons, idli batter 4 to 5 cups, oil 3 teaspoons and salt to taste. Let's start. In a pressure cooker, add 1 cup of water and potatoes and cook it for 4 whistles. You can also slit the potatoes so that you can cook them faster. Once the pressure cooker releases its pressure, take out the potatoes, cool them down and peel the potatoes and mash them and keep aside. It should not be very saggy, it should be crumbly. In a pan, add oil. Once the oil is hot, add mustards. Let the mustard splutter. If you don't splutter the mustards properly, the flavors will not be released. Now add cumins, chana dal, urad dal, one by one, and saute till they are brown and crunchy. This is a similar potato curry what we make with masala dosas. Who don't love masala dosa? Now on, this stuffed idli will be also your favorite. Now add asafoetida and curry leaves and green chilies and fry for few seconds. Once the regular school starts, you can make the mini versions of these and pack it for your kids' lunchbox, and you will find the lunchbox empty when they return. Now add onions. Saute till they are transparent. If you are in a hurry and it is not possible to make everything from the scratch at the morning, you can keep this curry ready and use it with your regular idli batter in the morning. Add turmeric and fry it for a while. Now add grated carrots. Give it a nice mix. You can add any vegetables of your choice like capsicum, cabbage or French beans, whatever you like, but it should not leave water, it should be dry vegetables. Add salt. Add frozen peas now. If you are adding regular fresh peas, you have to add it immediately after onions. As frozen peas cooks faster compared to regular ones, I am adding it at the end, or else you have to add it at initially and give time for cooking. Close the lid and cook it for about 3 minutes. Meet you in a while. It is ready. Now add mashed potatoes and give it a nice mix. Potatoes are sticking, right? Use your spatula. Mix everything and saute for a while. Add chopped corianders. Check for salt. If you need it more, you can add it now. And once the curry is ready, take it to your bowl and keep it aside. Take small portions of ready potato curry and make them into small cutlets and keep it in a tray. The size should be really right depending on your idli plate's depth and the size of idlis you prefer. This will take a while. Grease the idli plates with ghee or oil. Side by, also keep your idli cooker ready for steaming. And now take the idli batter. It should be of this consistency. It should not be very thin or very thick. Pour little bit batter in each slot, approximately 2 spoons. Now place the stuffing cutlets which we had made in each slot. Now cover it with batter. don't over pour the batter or else your idlis tend to stick each other. Just the right amount. When all your plates are ready, stack them and steam them as you steam your regular idlis for about 20 to 25 minutes in a preheated idli cooker. Ensure that there is enough water in your idli cooker. Check if the idlis are ready by poking it with a wooden stick. Once ready, take it in a serving tray one by one. Surprise, surprise! Ta-da! I'm sure you have loved this surprise. Like this video? Comment your cooking experience below. 10 steamy potato curry stuffed idlis are ready. Serve it with chutney of your choice and ghee. Serve it with a smile. Thank you. Bye-bye. Please like, share, comment on this video. Subscribe to Avi's Delights for more yummy recipes. Don't forget to press the bell icon.